Dear students, welcome to today's fluid mechanics class. Today we are going to start our new chapter, chapter number 4, that is flow through pipe. Up to this stage, we have studied the flow of fluid through pipe without considering the detailed analysis of energy losses. We have done very minor studies about the energy losses in flow. But in actual practice, due to various losses in the pipe, those losses are called major loss and minor loss, the total head, that is P by rho g, pressure head, plus V square by 2g, velocity head, plus z, that is the potential, does not remain constant and decreases. As flow take place from one point to next point, continuously this total head reduces due to major loss and minor losses in the pipe. Because these losses absorb the energy of the fluid. So, I would like to classify the various losses in the pipe. At this initial stage, you need to know that what types of losses are there in the pipe in a flowing fluid. I have branched all the losses here. This is the heading energy loss through pipe. There are two types of losses. One is major loss and other is minor loss. Basically, major loss is the frictional loss. It is indicated by H small f in the foot of the edge, and this frictional loss is determined by the two equations. It may be determined by either Darcy equation or it may be determined by the Chagas equation. The derivation of these both two equations we will see in next classes. So, these are the major loss in the pipe. And what are the minor loss? These are also important. Minor loss are basically, six types of minor loss are there in the pipe. Number one, due to sudden expansion of the pipe. Means, one pipe is there and after that, we connected a other pipe with big diameter, means sudden expansion of the pipe. At that stage, there is a loss of the head in the flow and it is indicated by HE. Next one is the due to sudden contraction of the pipe. Suppose there is a big diameter pipe and after that we have connected a small diameter pipe. In that case also, there are some head loss in the flowing fluid, that is indicated by HC. C stands for contraction. Here E stands for expansion. Number three, due to inlet of the pipe. It is indicated by H suffix I. Next one is due to outlet of the pipe. It is indicated by H suffix O. And next is due to bend in the pipe. Suppose some bend in the pipe, then at the point of bend there will be some head loss, energy loss of the flowing fluid. number 6 minor loss number 6 that is due to fitting in the pipe. Suppose there are various types of fitting in the pipe. Suppose wall is connected somewhere in the pipe and somewhere union is connected and somewhere some nipple is connected. Different types of fittings are there in the pipe that I will not going to discuss. But if there is a fitting in between the flow in a pipe, at that point there will be loss of head due to that fitting, and that will be indicated by H suffix capital F. Let us see one by one that how to mathematically formulate the minor losses through the pipe. Here we need to know only formula to calculate the minor losses. We will not go in detailed derivation of each and every minor loss. Here our interest is only that how mathematically we will calculate the minor loss. So one by one we see that how we will calculate the minor head losses. Number one, head loss due to sudden expansion, HE suffix. Suppose this is the small pipe, section 1-1, indicating one section of the small pipe, and it is a section 2 of the, after this small pipe there is a fitting of big pipe. So here when the fluid will enter from this pipe to this pipe, then there will be sudden expansion. So it is called as sudden expansion. There will be some loss of the fluid energy. Suppose this in this small pipe there is velocity of the fluid is V1, and in this bigger pipe the velocity of fluid is V2. So then we can calculate by this formula the head loss due to sudden expansion, HE is equal to V1 minus V2 whole square divided by 2G, where G is the acceleration due to gravity. Let us see next minor loss. That is the head loss due to sudden contraction, indicated by H suffix E. Suppose there is a big pipe, after that there is a small pipe. So here is a sudden contraction of the flowing fluid. For the flowing fluid, let us consider two sections, one section here in the big pipe and other section here in the small pipe. So when fluid will enter from big pipe to small pipe, then at a certain distance there will be a minimum diameter of the flowing fluid. As I have discussed earlier, that it is called vena contracta. This minimum diameter is called vena contracta. I had discussed it in orifice meter. Yes, I had discussed it in orifice meter. So when fluid will start to enter here, the stream will initially enter in the small pipe, then slowly its diameter will, the diameter of stream will reduce, and again the diameter of stream will increase, and it will take the shape of the small pipe. So at this place where there is a minimum diameter of the fluid flow, it is called vena contracta. Suppose here is the cross section area is AC, then and A1 is the area of the this bigger pipe that we need not to know, and A2 is the area of the this small pipe, then coefficient of contraction will be AC by A2. And here the loss due to sudden contraction will be given by HC is equal to in bracket 1 by CC minus 1 whole square V2 square by 2G. Here CC is the coefficient of contraction, and V2 square is the velocity of flow in the this small pipe. So let us take one example. If we take CC is equal to 0.62, then the value of this coefficient of contraction will come 0.375 V2 square by 2G. Suppose if we are not given the coefficient of contraction, then we can take the loss due to sudden contraction as CC, here will be HC, by mistake I have written CC, HC is equal to 0.5 V2 square by 2G. Next loss, head loss at the inlet of the pipe. Suppose from the tank, the fluid is going to enter in the pipe. So it will be one example of the inlet. So at the inlet of the pipe, where from some tank the fluid will enter in a pipe, it will called as inlet. And at the inlet there will be some loss of the head, and this loss will be indicated by h suffix small I, and it will be given by 0.5 v square by 2g, where v is the velocity of flow in inlet pipe. And next loss is minor loss number 4 is head loss at the outlet of the pipe. It will be indicated by h suffix small o. Suppose this is the pipe and fluid is flowing out from the pipe. So at the outlet of the pipe, head loss will be calculated as h is equal to v square by 2g, where v is the velocity of flow in the pipe by 2g. Where V is the outlet velocity. Next loss. Loss number 5 is the head loss due to bend in the pipe. Suppose it is a bend in the pipe and fluid is flowing from this side to this side. Then at the bend there will be a loss of the head, and it will be given by H suffix B is equal to KB V square by 2G. Here V is the velocity of flow in pipe through bend, and KB is equal to coefficient of the bend. Next loss is the loss number 6, that is the head loss due to fitting in the pipe. It will be indicated by H suffix capital F. Capital F because small f will be used for the frictional head loss in the pipe. So for the fitting loss, it will be H suffix capital F. So due to fitting, the loss in the pipe will be calculated at the fitting will as below. HF is equal to KF V square by 2G, where KF is the coefficient of fitting, V is the velocity of flow through pipe. In this way, all the 6 losses, minor losses, we can calculate by using the given formula. We need to know only the formula. The derivation is not required in our scope. Next we will see one important thing, that is the Reynolds number. What is the Reynolds number? In 1883, Osborne Reynolds did few experiments and established a dimensionless formula, which will be given as RE means Reynolds number, and the formula which Mr. Reynolds established, that is RE is equal to rho dV by mu. It is called the Reynolds number. Let us see what is the rho, what is the d, and what is the v, what is the mu, one by one. Here in the Reynolds number, rho is the density of flowing fluid, and d is the diameter of the pipe through which fluid is flowing, and v is the velocity of flow through pipe, and mu is equal to coefficient of dynamic viscosity. We write again this R is equal to rho dV by mu, And by rearranging this formula, we are taking this d below this mu, mu by d. As starting chapter, we had studied that mu by d is equal to kinematic viscosity, that indicated by this symbol, what I have written here. And again, this formula, Reynolds number, can be written as r is equal to rho v by this kinematic viscosity. So what is the significance of this formula? Mr. Reynolds given on the basis of experiment that if this the value of Reynolds number is less than 2000, the flow will be laminar. If the value of Reynolds number will be greater than 4000, then flow will be turbulent. And if by case this Reynolds number lies between this 2000 and 4000, the flow may be laminar or may be turbulent. Now let us see some basics about this frictional losses, that is the major loss. Frictional loss. I will start with the William Fraud experiment on the frictional losses in the pipe. Mr. William Fraud did various experiments on the fluid friction losses through the pipe and concluded that fluid friction in the pipe is proportional to the V square, where V is the velocity of flowing fluid in the pipe. Fluid friction is proportional to the area of contact. Suppose diameter of pipe is D and we consider the length L of the pipe, then the fluid friction will be directly proportional to pi DL. This is the area of contact. Next, depends, fluid friction depends on the nature of contact surface. And Mr. William Fraud formulated this as fluid friction directly proportional to pi DL V square. And if we remove this proportionality, we get a constant, it is called, it is indicated by F dash. And it's depend upon the material of the pipe and surface roughness of the pipe material. Means this F dash depends on the material of the pipe, number one, and roughness, surface roughness of the pipe. These two things on which this F dash depends. So let us see now laws of fluid friction. First, for laminar flow, what are the law of fluid friction? Number A, fluid friction depends upon the flow velocity. Number two, fluid friction depends upon contact surface area, contact surface area. Law next law, independent of the pressure of the fluid. Next, independent of the nature of the contact surface. Next, affected by temperature variation in flowing fluid. These are the 5 points which are called as the law of fluid friction for laminar flow. And what are the law of fluid friction for turbulent flow that I have written here? Number one, fluid friction depends upon the flow velocity. Fluid friction depends upon the fluid density. Next, fluid friction depends upon the area of contact. Next, fluid friction is independent of pressure of flowing fluid. Next is, fluid friction depends upon the nature of contact surface. Next is fluid friction slightly affected by temperature variation of the flowing fluid. So in this way we have covered in this class that what is the classification of losses, various types of losses in a pipe. We have seen there are two types of losses, major losses, minor losses, and there are six types of minor losses. One by one, all the minor losses, how to calculate by formula, we have seen. And we have seen that how Mr. William Fraud formulated frictional loss, that is a major loss in the pipe. And what are the laws of laminar fluid friction and law of fluid friction for laminar flow, law of fluid friction for turbulent flow. So in next class we will see that how to calculate the major loss by Darcy equation and Chazy equation. We will derive that equation in next class, Darcy equation and Chazy equation. And after that we will try to solve some numericals on the basis of this major and minor losses. So it is very important guideline for you that you submit timely your assignment. You submit timely means when I will upload and send to you, after that within 12 hours you submit your assignment, within 12 hours. And the file name should be as per I have guided to you earlier, that what should be the file name. That file should be PDF, and as I upload the video, you watch the video in the YouTube, and in comment box you put your roll number so that I will understand that you have watched that video. And the file name properly, timely submitted assignment, and that notes that is your assignment will decide your attendance in the class. Thank you.